House Armed Services Committee Chairman Buck McKeon challenging the credibility of Brigadier General Robert Lovell's testimony that more should have been done to help Americans in Benghazi. Lovell, said McKeon, did not serve in a capacity that gave him reliable insight into operational options available to commanders during the attack, nor did he offer specific courses of action not taken. We have no evidence that Department of State officials delayed the decision to deploy what few resources DOD had available to respond. Joining us now, our guests, members of the House Oversight Committee who attended that hearing today. Joining us now is Congressman Blake Farenthold, Congresswoman Cynthia Lummis. Thank you both for being here. And if I may, Congresswoman, I'm going to begin with you. That was quite an extraordinary hearing. And General Lovell's testimony, disconcerting in that no one asked for help during that entire tragic ordeal.
Lou, I wish that Chairman McKeon had been in our hearing today and listened firsthand to what we heard from Brigadier General retired Lovell. He told us that he was in Stuttgart, Germany, mm-hmm. in real time as events were unfolding in Benghazi, and that as they were filtering from Stuttgart to Washington, D.C., the information as they had it coming into them, that they were not getting direction from civilian leadership, the people that they normally would hear from and receive direction from to respond. And I asked him, what would normally be the response? And his words were, go, go, go. And I asked him, why didn't they say go? As a result, four Americans are dead.
And still, the question remains when we talk about civilian leadership, as you just did, Congresswoman. Congressman Farenthold, we still don't know where Hillary Clinton, the Secretary of State, was on this. We don't know where the President of the United States was. We don't know why no one was, as the Congresswoman reiterated, no one was saying go, go, go to the assistance of fellow Americans under attack in Benghazi.
And that's a real problem. You know, the general testified that their training is to run to the sound of gunfire. And, you know, we talk about there not being resources available. We didn't even get resources on the way. We didn't know how long this was going to last. We should have had people in the air headed that direction. And of course, they could have been recalled in the event the situation changed. But nobody even started. And the question that bothers me the most is, if America can't respond to an emergency endangering the lives of our diplomats anywhere in the world in a matter of hours, why can't we do that? There's something wrong. We ought to be able to get there.
Chairman Issa made it very clear that he was going to listen dispassionately to what the general had to say and build a record. The record is pretty clear on this, yet we hear from Chairman McKeon not long after your committee adjourns its hearing, basically following the same talking point and, if you will, following the same stratagem as the Democrat members on your committee, trying to dismiss the capacity of the military to have reacted. What in the world is going on with the Republican chairman of armed services? Is this petulant competitive committees led by Republicans at work here, or is there something else going on? Congresswoman,
Lou,
your thoughts?
You bet. Blake and I are on oversight and government reform. On that committee, we don't have an agenda. We're following the testimony, the depositions, the emails, the written word, and the testimony we receive live. And today's testimony from Brigadier General Lovell confirmed his written statements. They track with what Ben Rhodes's statement was. In other words, while our people who are in harm's way and were reporting about the people who were in harm's way were reporting it to Washington, D.C., to the civilian leadership right. of this country, the civilian leaders in this country were trying to figure out how to spin it for the Sunday news shows.
Is there any question in your mind that the assets in Italy, assets near Libya, could have been diverted and brought to bear, whether they be jets or whether they be special operations forces, to try at least to help those people who are being attacked by radical Islamist terrorists.
They didn't even start, Lou. That's the problem.
Did we have the capacity to do so? Because that very much seems to be the question, and if you will, the tactic that is introduced by the Democrats. Your Armed Services Committee Chairman, Buck McKeon.
Well, I think we did have some resources in place in Italy, Spain, and Germany. And if we didn't, we should have. And one of the takeaways from this is we need to evaluate our ability to respond to a crisis anywhere in the world on short notice. And, you know, a lot of people say this is all about sticking it to the White House or Hillary Clinton. No, this investigation also serves to make sure the men and women who serve in our diplomatic corps can feel safe and feel like they've got Washington, D.C. behind them when they're out in hostile territory risking their lives for American interests.
Congressman Farenthold, thank you so much. Congresswoman Lummis, thank you both for being here tonight. Thanks.
Our pleasure.
Absolutely.
Thank you.